So many people have looked at how could we use wind and solar energy and get less carbon, but there's a problem. It basically, the wind doesn't blow all the time and it doesn't blow everywhere. So our study basically said, if we looked at a large area, could you get inexpensive and reliable electric power? And we were able to show that we can.
The bottom line of this study that we did is that the model predicts that we can get to 80% reduction in carbon emissions compared to 1990 without a dramatic increase in cost of electricity.
I think what we were really looking at is we really felt that because of the large scale of weather, that we could show that we can really decrease our carbon emissions without changing the cost. And that's exactly what our study came up with. You can have power that is about the same cost as today retail.
So every hour by hour, the wind and solar combined together will produce a vast majority of the power that's needed, and the rest is backed up by fossil fuels in our optimization.
So in our study, we really had to have the hour by hour amount of sun available, because we're really saying, gee, if there's wind available, we'll use that. If there's sun available, if it's available in part of the US and not another part. So the study really has to have all detailed weather data every hour for an entire year to really determine what the wind and solar resources are.
The wind happens to be over large scales, and at the moment the existing infrastructure for energy is actually on small scales, and that's just been a historical artifact through time. And what we actually need to integrate these renewable sources cost effectively is to build these systems on the scale of weather. And so that means that we have to build transmission lines, or so the model says, is build transmission lines across the US to connect these distant regions together to provide power cheaply.
Eisenhower said, gee, we need interstate highways, because if you manufacture in one part of the US, we want to be able to bring it elsewhere. It turns out that electricity is the same way.
The highway system, the interstate highway system, is a very good analogy, because it allows access to remote areas that might have richer resources than your local vicinity, and which will drive down prices across the whole.